Professor Surya is from our, you know, IIT Bombay PhD. So I'm extremely glad and thank you so much, Surya, for joining. And I like the name a lot, ITIC. You know, ITIC is the incubator in IIT Hyderabad, and Surya will take over from here. Thanks, Surya. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Professor Chakravarti. In fact, I mean, it's a pleasure joining. I will not go into details of what entrepreneurship journey is. So this will be more like a listing of the data for what you can get from IIT Hyderabad. I mean, the funding sources, the programs running, etc. Your academic options, etc. is what will be my focus of the talk also. Okay. I mean, innovation is very generic. Okay. You can have an idea. Okay, and if you give it to an industry through IP transfer or through technology transfer, and that is happening through R&D cell, and that's typical commercialization. But if you don't want to just give it to a different third party, okay, but own it yourself and create a startup or create a business entity out of that idea yourself, that essentially is what we are focusing today. In the form of entrepreneurship. Okay, so commercialization and entrepreneurship are not exactly same. Commercialization is you doing it yourself or you selling it to a company. So for example, we do a lot of R&D work for Tata Steel or Boeing or anything. Okay, that's just pure commercialization of the technology. Whereas in entrepreneurship, we are also worried about, focus is on you starting your own company or take that idea yourself. Champion that idea yourself. Okay. So there are various terms you had come across, and there are so many that it keeps gets confusing also occasionally. Even many of us are not clear what is the role of entrepreneurship and management department versus entrepreneurship cell, okay, or e-cell and incubator. And incubator, ITIC incubator, or CFHE incubator, or Fabulous incubator. Okay, I take that as a backend compliment because we have so many things happening. Okay, and so many parallel things happening. You can do the same thing in multiple different manners. Okay, and I think that's essentially the whole idea here. So, but I will try to give some little rationalization where which fits here. Etc. Okay, but you have decent, you have minor academic initiatives in entrepreneurship. The course currently is perfectly fits the bill. You have a center in healthcare entrepreneurship, you have IT incubator, you have fabulous chip incubator, you have a technology research park, all this. So, I think all the various entities. So, I'll try to make sense of this. From an entrepreneurship point of view, how an entrepreneurship journey begins. Okay, so one is you have an inclination, you have interest for being an entrepreneur. That's what we call as germination stage. Okay, so you get an idea or we create interest in you to be an entrepreneur in the future. Then you start learning what are the basics of entrepreneurship, what it means, what is a business plan, or what it means to convert an idea into a successful model, etc. Then you develop your own startup idea, you work on your own technological idea. After that, you create and work on the way, maybe in tandem with academics or in tandem with your incubation ecosystem. And subsequently, you create a viable prototype. From prototype, you go into commercialization, etc. And then you scale up and you become a successful company. Okay. So this is generally loosely how you can put the entrepreneurship journey. This we typically refer, okay, so most of the ads or most of the calls for incubation, etc. also use the same terminology. So we categorize them as germination stage where, you're not clear what to do, but there is a idea cooking in your mind, so to say, okay. And slowly that idea is taking shape, and then pre-incubation stage is where that idea takes a more concrete form. So you're not just interested in becoming an entrepreneur, but you're also trying to figure out which company, which domain, which sector you're going to work. Okay. And in the third stage, what we call as incubation stage, after you have decided that, okay, I want to be an entrepreneur and I want to work on, for example, creating a robot or a 3D printer, or a AI algorithm for drone control, etc. The third stage is where you start working on that product and take it to commercial level, etc. Fourth is, I mean, so where you kind of have some business traction, everything is ready, and you are finding more and more customers, you are finding more and more value addition for that. And then finally, you create a successful company out of it. Okay, so these accordingly are catered in by these various cells, if you look at it. Okay, so the initial enthusiasm and the initial interest and how and what it means to be an entrepreneur is mostly driven by the student-driven activities like ESL, etc. So a lot of activities they take. And I mean, it is completely Gymkhana driven. So they do excellent set of workshops, set hackathons, etc. for creating the interest in the minds of the students. Then you have kind of know what is it means to be an entrepreneur. What are the basics of entrepreneurship? So you have courses like Myron Entrepreneurship, courses on entrepreneurship. Okay, and even we have recently started a dual degree program in technical entrepreneurship, etc. Then you develop your own idea with the help of course, academics and innovation mentors. So they also have innovation mentors from every department. There are 15 innovation mentors identified for each department. So they are like your go-to point. So any doubt, any of these things, I mean, you can, of course, approach any of the colleagues who are here today, or any of these innovation mentors who are available for you in your respective departments or in a cross-disciplinary department, etc. also. After all that, that's essentially your germination stage. Then you want to kind of start the journey and initiate. So there are two ways you can do it. One is in tandem with your academics. So that means you want to get a degree out of it, frankly speaking. Okay. So there is a techno entrepreneurship which is started, dual degree program. And also he gives summer semester break for internship, for incubation, etc. also is possible. So you can actually officially take a break in your sixth semester. You do, I think all of you know that in your sixth semester, you can take a semester break for doing internship. And what we are looking is that internship need not be in a third party company, but can be also in your own incubator. So the same six semester break, we are looking at extending for incubation and startup related activities also. Or I mean, subsequently you can take a semester break and or even a year break if depending on the analysis. I mean, there will be a committee naturally, but it is possible. Okay, so that's part from the academics point of view. Also, apart from academics, if you want to start your own incubation journey formally, so to say, okay, then you have you can have fellowship programs at our incubators. So CFHE is there, MITI. We have a couple of grants and a couple of programs. I will go into these subsequently. But for example, the nature of these grants is you just have an idea and nothing else. Okay, you can come present your idea, then who will give you, let us say, 4 lakhs or 10 lakhs according to the program and according to your listing for converting that idea into a prototype. For building that prototype, who will give you the necessary money? Okay, I mean, so it depends. Okay, so it can be 4 lakhs to 10 lakhs depending on the domain. So if you're a software, we'll usually don't give more than 4 lakhs. If you're working on a physical prototype, you're creating some machine, creating some entity, then we can go up to 10 lakhs also. Okay. So these are some formal fellowship programs, what we call as EAR, Early Entrepreneurship in Residence, etc. program. So there is even a provision in some of these programs to give you sustenance money also, so that you don't just lose your salary and are not in a pressure to start earning. You can even sustain, I mean, some basic sustenance, of course. Okay, so you get money for sustaining yourself and you get money for building the prototype also in addition.
Till the pre-incubation, mm-hmm. can they do it as their thesis project for the MDes students?
Right now, no. It expects a full-time commitment. So if they are student, not full-time, they do not get the sustenance money, but they get the prototype money.
Oh, that's quite good. Yeah, yeah. Even that is very okay. Nice. Because
so, I mean, if they are 100% full-time, they get the sustenance money also.
Oh, I see. Which is after their MDes program, they want to continue for another 6 months, they get that.
So in fact, I mean, so this is mostly common for PhD students, frankly. Okay. Right. Because PhD students in their third year or fourth year come up with the idea and they think it is worth also starting a startup during their PhD or as part, I mean, parallel with their PhD also. Mm-hmm. Okay. The only catch is we expect a no objection from the guide and the institute for any student to enter. But we are open from our side. If the guide and, I mean, if the department allows, we are good. Okay. So from our side, we allow it. Yes. So they can do it parallelly as part of their PhD program or as part of their master's thesis program also in the US. That's right. Okay. So these are some schemes available formally at the pre-incubation stage. And once all that is done, once you have kind of, yes, this is my idea, this is my product, which is going to work, I would go to the market with this product. Then is when your incubation journey starts. So this is more formal now. Okay. So all the previous stages are you as an individual, as a Surya, as a XYZ person. Okay. Now the startup journey, it's no longer about an individual. It is about a company. You are expected to form a company. You are expected to register a company and share and all equity, et cetera, also come into the picture from here, this point. Okay. And our rules also facilitate that any work you do, yes, part after starting the incubation, IP also belongs to you. Okay. So it's not just, so for example, I mean, you know, the typical rules. Okay. Any IP, any work done by any student or any faculty of IIT during as part of their academic activities or work responsibilities belong to the IIT Hyderabad. Okay. I mean, belong to the respective IIT. Okay. But we are also creating rules where it's not just that you create your startup, but the engagement you do. So for example, if you are a student and do your own startup, the IP belongs to the startup, not necessarily to the institute. Or same is the case with faculty also. A faculty, for example, I can, if I do any research, the IP belongs to IIT Hyderabad. But let us say if I start do a startup today and I create my own startup and I do research with funding from the startup. Okay. I mean, it's not fair that I use institute money and take the money I keep from the startup. So if the money for the R&D comes from the startup, my own involvement, notwithstanding, the IP belongs to the startup. Okay. So that is something we are looking. So, I mean, so everything you do as part of the work, okay, belongs to the startup, belongs to that entity. Okay. Including your IP, including the support, everything. And so naturally that's the incubation stage. It's typically transfer, 2 years maximum. Okay. And then, accelerator stage is subsequently, I think for most of you, it's not relevant, but let us say if you are a startup who has a 2 or 3 experience and wants to grow and research startup. And I mean, you don't want support, but you want a footprint in the campus, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. So I will cover those two, but I think the first three are of significant relevance for us, the germination stage, the pre-incubation and the incubation stages. Okay. So this is how these entities are. Okay. So you have entrepreneurship cell acting in the germination stage. You have academic activities stage. You have pre-incubation by CFHE, by IT, by FAPC, et cetera. Okay. Then you have a host of other activities also. You have Department of Entrepreneurship, you have Institute Innovation Council, you have IP cell to facilitate all these activities also. And so firstly, the academic initiatives. So there are host of them in IIT Hyderabad. So one is your minor, one is your thing. I will not go into the details here, but I mean, the idea is that students should be given provision to work on their startup idea, not just after their degree, but even during their degree. And it's not something which is unconventional. The idea is we allow students to work on industry projects. Okay. I mean, and we take it as a matter of pride that we are allowing students to go for internship. We allow students to go for industry internships, etc. Okay. And it's just the corollary of the same concept is, if a industry need not be just a big industry, but your own startup, your own incubator also, okay? So if we allow you to work in Tata Steel, if we allow you to work in Wipro or Boeing, we can definitely allow you to also work on your own startup, okay? So there is no harm. And in fact, I think we should encourage, okay? So these are some initiatives we are having in that regard, okay? Then you have incubations, formal incubators in IIT. Okay. So formal incubators are entities where we deal with the business side of it. Okay. So the technical side of it are always with the your I mean departments. Okay, so I mean the idea you're working, the startup idea you have related to your incubation, I mean maybe artificial intelligence code or some robot program, anything depends on your respective departments. But incubators look at the formal aspect of it, the business angle of it. Okay, and we have three active incubators at IIT Hyderabad, ITIC, which covers all the deep tech. So this is like the default incubator, which is DST funded. So I mean, and other two are very focused and specialized incubators for specific for a domain. Okay, so CFH is Center for Healthcare Entrepreneurship, which focuses on healthcare entrepreneurship, as the name itself suggests. And then we have an incubator for FabC, that is Fabless Chip Design, which focuses mostly on the electronic and communications, etc. And if you're not sure, if you're not fall into either of this, ITIC is the default one. Okay, all deep tech ideas, all deep tech arenas come into the ITIC. Okay, so ITIC is EST recognized incubation system. Okay, and CFHE is a private funded incubator, which is funded from alum funds, etc. And Fabless Chip Design Incubator is supported from MeitY, Ministry of Information Technology and Electronics. So FabC particularly is meant as a one-stop solution for all chip design related startups. Okay, and they have very great number of EDA tools, which typically cost around multiple number of crores. Such softwares are available as facilities in this incubator. So the idea here is to encourage working in electronics and particularly chip design context. And they have a beautiful prototyping facility and a characterization facility, etc. also available. Okay, so if you are a startup working in this domain, then FabC is the right partner. And CFHE is Center for Healthcare Entrepreneurship. They have a fellowship program as their flagship program. So they have mentors, they have clinical partnership, they also give you seed funding, etc. So in fact, there is also a program called MTech in Healthcare Entrepreneurship, which is recently started. So it's a beautiful program where three people have come together. IIT Hyderabad, that is an academic institution, a incubator, CFHE, and three, the hospital, I think the Asian gastro, this thing, okay. So a hospital, a academic institution, and an incubator are combinedly running this MTech program. So it has the right mix of partnership and mentors with focus on healthcare entrepreneurship domain. Third incubator, that is ITIC incubator, which I also take care of. So this is a technology business incubator, which is funded and supported by DST, Department of Science and Technology. It is a non-profit, it is registered as a non-profit society and gone by an independent board, but essentially with the members of IIT Hyderabad and other eminent people as a board. Okay, so our areas are all deep tech areas, including AI, ML, aerospace, telecommunication, manufacturing, robotics, sensors, biomedical, automotive. So I mean, so all deep tech areas, we are welcome here. Okay. So what is our mandate? Our mandate is look at essentially a student or a faculty in a lab who has a brilliant technical idea, but is clueless about anything else. Okay, is clueless about how to convert that idea into a business entity, how to form a company, how to create shares, how to get a GST certificate, how to get a registration, how to get a startup registration certificate, etc. Okay, so he just has the technical idea, but is clueless about anything related to business. So that's our role. Okay, so we help in nurturing that idea into a business entity, into a company, his own company, her own company. We provide small working space with basic facilities for that. We provide business mentorship. We have close to 100 business mentors, from practicing businessmen, successful businessmen, who can, you can get in touch with and take their opinion, whether is it a successful, is it going to work, is it not going to work, any feedback such like that. And we can also provide technical assistance to nurture that idea. So for example, if the journey is multidisciplinary, so you may be a mechanical guy, but you may require, for example, a chemical engineering understanding or a AI understanding, etc. Okay, so we bring in innovation mentors who can support that, nurturing that idea. And in some cases, we can even provide you seed funding. So we can, I mean, so there are funding options where 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, up to 25 lakhs, it is possible for you to get some seed funding also to create your incubator. And naturally, we don't give it all this as a free. So we take 3 to 6% of your company shares as a, in exchange for all the facilities we are providing. So that means if your company is successful and you make tons of money, we make money, okay? And so we have a vested interest in seeing you successful, okay? I mean, so we keep saying, I mean, your success is not just your success, indirectly our success also, okay? So it's not just from the brand perspective, but from our monetary perspective also. Okay, so and naturally, if you fail, we fail. Okay, so I mean, so it means everything we're giving is, I mean, at free cost. Okay, so that's all part of the journey. Okay, so all this we take in an equity model.
Surya, how many years do you let them stay on the campus? How many years after their graduation they can stay on the campus?
Essentially, the problem is accommodation is not yet available in the campus for incubation related students. So they have to, I mean, so they can work from the campus, office space and working space will be provided, but not hostel space. That's the challenge.
But even that, how many years? 3 years or 4 years?
Our incubation is, if it is pre-incubation, it is 1 year. If it is incubation startup, 2 years.
Oh, I see. Very nice.
2 years is the standard. So typically 2 years is incubation journey. So we allow. And I mean, it is possible to extend up to 3 years if the committee agrees, but generally we don't advise them to stay longer. If an idea does not succeed in 2 years, it's not going to succeed in 10 years. That's kind of our look at it.
The major thing about this incubator students is the ecosystem. So you have a lot of other entrepreneurs around you, a lot of visitors coming in. Because of IIT, you'll get a lot of synergy, a lot of people coming in, a lot of labs around, visitors around. In fact, you know, yesterday the two examples you saw, you know, even Amitabh Kant actually visited the incubator. He gave a lot of leads for businesses. So the whole advantage, you know, is pretty large of being on campus, of course, staying outside and be your office is on campus, and you know, which is very, very advantageous. Actually, you get the whole synergy and the network, you know, alumni network, the industry network, you know, like coming in and, you know, supporting you.
True. That's very true. In fact, I mean, we also make sure that our startups have fairly good access to the facilities, in research facilities in IIT Hyderabad available. So that is our sort of, say, the mandate we at incubator. We are not just an incubator, we are a deep tech incubator. Okay, so a Kirana shop is also a business. A furniture shop is also a business. And they're respectable businesses. But we don't support them. We only support where there is a value addition in terms of a technical value addition to the coming up. Okay. So if you have a unique nanofiltration methodology, you have a unique algae cleaning or a nice drone navigation algorithm or a battery technology for UV, there should be, end of the day, a technical value addition from the startup coming. What we qualify as deep tech. Okay, so those startups only we take up, and that is essentially what differentiates IIT technology startups, IIT rooted startups from, for example, T-Hub or other general incubators. They support all kinds of startups as business entities. We only take and support deep tech entrepreneurship startups. There should be something technical about your startup. On the other hand, it should also have commercial angle. Okay, so if you write a new beautiful project proposal on catalysis efficiency increase of some XYZ chemicals, it's more like your PhD thesis topic rather than your startup idea. So no, we don't support that either. Okay, so I mean, it should be technical with a commercial angle. So that's something very important for our startups. So, and we have a lot of schemes and terms. So we have Nidhi Accelerator, Nidhi Prayas, NMDC, NICE program, BEL program, TIHAN program. I will briefly talk about these programs now. Okay. But which program is right for you depends more on what is the stage of your startup and what is the domain of your startup also. Some of these startups programs are, for example, for electronic startups. Some are pure physical, mechanical prototype startups. Some are all areas, some are electronics only. Okay, some are autonomous navigation. So it depends on the domain. And it also depends on the stage of your startup. Is it a early stage? Is it you're fairly mature, etc.? So that is something, I mean, you should have clarity. If you have that clarity, we can help you, which is the right problem. So we have all these programs at ITIC. So germination stage, pre-incubation stage, incubation stage, etc. So this is the impact of ITIC as of today. Okay, so I mean, we have been officially registered in 2014. I think almost 6-7 years since we are registered. And I mean, so naturally, if you compare with IIT Madras or IIT Kanpur or IIT Bombay startups, ours is a more humbler one. But at least in these 5-6 years, we are able to generate good numbers. We have close to 70 startups which have been supported. They have funded up to 5 crores for the startups from different funding agencies. We could create 100 crores in startup revenues, okay? And close to 800 jobs have been created through our startups. We have mentorships associated with more than 150 mentors. And we have a 1.5 lakh square feet incubation park coming up. I will talk about it more in detail. So this is all the impact ITIC could generate during these years. And so these are some of our grant agencies and program partners. So naturally, not a penny comes from us directly. And we don't take a penny from IIT Hyderabad. We are also very proud of that. We don't take a single penny from IIT Hyderabad. We are completely self-sustainable. All the incubators are completely self-sustainable. They generate the money from either CSR funds or PSUs or any other projects, etc. Okay, so we have, of course, the major one is always the DST, the Department of Science and Technology. We have a beautiful program from NMDC, NICE, TIHAN, Nidhi Prayas. So I'll talk, I mean, some of them in detail. But I mean, so these are all been our partners and grant agencies who have helped us in the past as well as currently. And so these are just the programs currently at ITIC. I will not spend too much time here. I will glance through. So one is the NICE program. It is essentially a joint program by NMDC. So just like ONGC has created a joint program with SAIN Mumbai, NMDC, National Mineral Organization, has created a joint program with IIT Hyderabad. So it's, I mean, the name NICE comes from NMDC Innovation and Incubation Center. So here, up to 5 incubators in a year we give, and then subsequently a seed money of approximately 25 lakhs is also given under this program. So it is one of our flagship programs.
The fellowship, the fellowship is the stipend type of thing. The fellowship is
The fellowship covers both prototype as well as living expenses together. And two, in addition, we also have a maker lab created as part of this program itself. We have a beautiful, we have almost like 5 different 3D printers, laser cutters. We have a AR/VR setup developed. We have a even dark room setup developed. And I mean, all the basic fabrication tools, everything are available where the student, I mean, incubators can make use of it free of cost. Okay, so they need not frankly go and spend money also, except for the raw material. Okay, so that's the facilities available in the NICE program. And then the other program is our Asia, that is an accelerator program, not an incubation program. It's like an advanced. So we have, this was done together with Action for India, a NGO, working in healthcare and other domain, and ITIC together. This was again funded by DST. So we had taken close to 29 startups. I mean, so this is purely social entrepreneurship. Okay, so that means essentially where entrepreneurship also has a social relevance. So for example, you may be agri-tech or you may be a health tech or you may be edu-tech. All these startups you have supported. And then the third one is a DST supported program called Nidhi Prayas. So this is a beautiful program where you have an idea and you want to create a prototype. This should be a physical prototype. It cannot be a coding. Okay. It should be a physical prototype. If you want to create a prototype, who will give you 10 lakhs of support to create that prototype? Okay. No, nothing conditions. You need not even create a startup. It is for an individual. You have an idea, you come, you apply, and you'll get the money. Simple. Okay, so that's kind of how this works. Of course, I mean, so the idea should be good. I mean, so when I mean simple, it assumes that your idea is very valid. Any student, I mean, BTech, MTech, BMDes, any student of IIT Hyderabad can apply and to build something, and they get straight away 1 lakh under the build product. So very early prototype, no constraints. Then they can apply here. One must be a full-time student. I mean, so full-time, so that means being a student, one cannot apply. It must be a full-time activity in Niji Prayas, because this is a DST-funded scheme. So some kind of rules from them apply here. The beauty of it is it only takes physical prototypes. If it is a purely software, it is not permitted in this program. Till now, we are having a call-based. So that means there will be a call for Niji Prayas applications, and you go to the website, you have a 1 month or a 2 weeks time to apply, etc. That is the current model. But in 2-3 months, we are going to have an open call. That means you can just go to the website, apply anytime in any of the program. And we will have the next cycle, essentially 4 months is a typical cycle time. We plan to do it at least 3 times in a year, roughly speaking. Then we have the TEHAN program, which is, so TEHAN is a national mission on autonomous navigation sanctioned by government, I mean, DST again. It's a 150 crore test bed setup, which is going to come up in IIT Hyderabad. So that is a separate entity, that is a separate society and everything. But we collaborate with them and we partner on the incubation and startup related aspect of the TEHAN. So all the autonomous navigation startup, all the battery, electronic vehicle, electric vehicle startups, etc., we support under this program. And so we have same, I mean, so we have seed fund up to 25 lakhs. We have entrepreneurship fellowship grant up to 10 lakhs possible in these schemes. And then we have Maiti Type 2, which is supported by Ministry of Information and Technology. This is purely for software startups and electronic startups. You have electronic related idea or electronic related startup idea. So we have two schemes under it. EIR schemes can give you up to 4 lakhs and grant can give you up to 7 lakhs. It is comparatively lower because it is not physical prototype. It is typically more in terms of electronics and software. So the costs are expected to be lower. So that is the reason why it is 4 lakhs and 7 lakhs here. And we also are a IDEX VO partner. So that is essentially Ministry of Defense has created its own startup called IDEX. So it is where all the military related innovation startups, so be it Navy, Army or Air Force, all those are taken up by the IDEX, which is like the Ministry of Defense official startup. And they go and implement this startup program through partner incubators. There are only a handful of such incubators. So ITIC is one of the IDEX partners also. So that means you can register with the Ministry of Defense and they support up to almost 1.5 crores in funding from their challenges for defense related applications. And once you get the funding approval from the system, you can choose to incubate at ITIC or any other place. So ITIC is one of the partners, defense ITIC partners there. And we have also seed fund from Bharat Heavy Electricals, particularly on naturally, I mean, electronic related startups, etc. So these are all now startups at ITIC. Okay, so I mean, we have close to 40 startups who are currently active at ITIC. So we have close to 5-6 of them are by faculty also. And another 5-6 are from students of ITIC, IIT Hyderabad. And the remaining are also from external students. So we allow both IIT Hyderabad faculty, IIT Hyderabad students, as well as external students in some proportion. We don't allow too many, but in a decent proportion, we have both external as well as campus based startups possible. One of our companies recently we have taken under the autonomous navigation program is Elog Industries. So they are working on creating the robots for autonomous warehouse management. Okay, so I mean, so all the, so for example, I mean, Flipkart or Amazon. Okay, so they're creating the mobile robots. They're fabricating the mobile robots. So not just the coding and the concept, but fabrication of the mobile robots for autonomous carts and autonomous navigation, order picking, etc. Okay. The idea is not really novel. Okay, you've seen enough videos of Amazon or other places, but the implementation capability in India is lagging. Okay, so you have hardly a startup today or any industry today who are capable of creating, manufacturing similar robots with automatic collision detection programming and everything. Okay, and at a scale, okay, not just one or two lab scale, but at a higher scale which will fit. Okay, so that is what the startup is planning to do. Okay, so then we also have one healthcare related startup from Auron Biomedical Engineering department, so Tejaswini. Okay, so the idea is to create a point of care, self-care testing device for cervical cancer detection. So we have kind of vaginal infections or cervical infections, etc. And you can create your own tool, self-tool for collection of the sample, etc. So this is one startup which is working in such self-care domain. We had good success with this startup also. Okay. And diametrically opposite is one of our startups, which is Manalis Wing. So they are interested in creating a bungee jump in Himachal Pradesh in India. Okay. So it's a good team of rock climbers and everything. Okay. So the idea is they will create a sort of a bungee jump equivalent between two peaks in one of the hill stations in Himachal Pradesh. Okay. And then facilitate jumping, etc. So challenge is not the jumping. The challenge is the detection. So they want to ensure all the automatic device detection, etc. So it automatically tells you whether the rope is tight or not, whether it is clamped properly or not, whether the person is standing at the right direction or not, right angle or not, etc., etc. Okay. So that's essentially how you can bring image learning and artificial intelligence to increase the safety in this jumping, etc., is what the company is doing. So another startup, which is again, in a different diameter, is GermSafe, which is working on disinfecting water, water purification. Okay. So maybe a hand water purification or a normal purification without having to do with your, chemicals or anything. Naturally, without using any pesticides or any chemicals, can you purify the water? Okay, and with a low cost, with a low membrane result, etc. So this is a team of three doctorates from in chemical engineering PhDs, okay, who are doing this work. Okay, so they are working on creating safe and affordable drinking water for rural applications, etc. So they've done some case studies, and in fact, they have been also recently shortlisted for the top five BRICS entrepreneurship award also. So here, they are starting their work on hand pumps, they are also looking at, let us say even municipal water purification and even milk purification also. So they use this, high cavitation flow. Okay. And they spin the water to kill the germs. So it does not remove the impurities, but it reduces the germs and this thing. Okay. So the boiling equivalent sort of. So it can help in reducing the need for water purification. And in many cases, at least, imagine, for example, even the warhead tank water becomes stale for 4 days. Okay. So how can you again make it potable and drinkable where there are no additional new impurities coming in, but where you want to reduce the germ content. Good. So this process is ideally suited for such a requirement. For particulate impurities, this is not suitable. Right. So if the impurities are, particulates like lead and all, this is not suitable. But so groundwater and all, depending on the source, it can be used for good application. So the intent is that we cover all the aspects. Okay. It can be rural healthcare, it can be fancy bungee jumping, it can be healthcare devices, or it can be industrial automation, etc. All these startups are welcome and are fit into our incubation system. So we also have a MHRD sanctioned research park, which is established in 2016. It is in very similar lines to IIT Madras Research Park. Okay, so this is completely, so if you are no longer a startup, but a mature company, and no longer fall into the startup category, you can hire, you can rent space here for your commercial operations and use the IIT Hyderabad campus and the facilities for your research activities. This is our future. So we have a 1.5 lakh square feet of technology incubation park, which is under construction. It's almost getting ready. So probably from 3 months to 6 months, we'll hope to have that facility ready. So this is designed and funded from JICA, that is Government of Japan support for IIT Hyderabad. So it comes from that division. And it is 1.5 lakh square feet of pure incubation space. So this complete building will only have incubation and startup related activities going on. Okay, so I think that will make it one of the, at least if not the biggest, one of the top three incubators, dedicated incubators in India. I mean, you have incubators, okay, but spread around this thing. So this is a single big entity building completely only dedicated to incubation activities. So we are hoping in another 3 months to 6 months, we'll have that ready. One of our major headaches was we want a combined ecosystem, but we want privacy. So let us say if I hire 4 different startups in autonomous navigation, one startup should not steal the ideas from the other startup. Okay. So, I mean, so our, but at the same time, we want an ecosystem where there is, I mean, a vibrancy of activity where you see, I mean, it typically happens, right? You see the other fellow putting a night out, you kind of get motivated to put a night out yourself. Okay, so that ecosystem. So this building is designed where privacy plus intermingling is happening. So it kind of, I mean, a beautiful amalgamation of these two. So it's designed in complete towers, and different towers have different floor levels and different heights, and each are connected, but each is an individual silo in itself. Okay, so that's briefly on all the activities of incubation and entrepreneurship at IIT Hyderabad. With that, I think I mean, so thank you, Professor Chakravarti.